everyone. Today I'll be explaining you how to interface a DC motor to LPC1768 ARM controller. As we know, a DC motor is a device which converts an electrical input to a mechanical energy, and it is converted in the form of a rotation. So DC motor basically, it is, as you know, it is used in fans, mixer grinders, etc. Now, in order to interface DC motor to the ARM controller device, we need to know the pin configuration of the DC motor that is connected to LPC1768 device. We can rotate this motor in two directions, clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction. The DC motor is connected to LPC1768 in the port 4. We are using two pins of port 4, that is 28th pin and 29th pin. Now these two pins, they are used to control the direction of rotation of the DC motor. If you want to rotate the DC motor in the clockwise direction, we are supposed to make pin number 8 of port 4 as equal to 1 and pin number 29 has to be made as equal to 0. Similarly, if you want to rotate the DC motor in the anti-clockwise direction, you are supposed to make pin number 28 as equal to 0 and pin number 29 as equal to 1 in port 4. Now, another important thing that we must remember, before starting any of the conversion, we are supposed to enable first the DC motor. The enable pin for the DC motor is given in port 2, that is the 8th pin of pin number port number 2. If it is made as equal to 1, then only your motor can start the rotation either in the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Coming to the next part, this is the kit that we'll be using here in the lab. As we know, this is the part that is used for connecting the DC motor externally, and this is the pin where we'll be connecting the DC motor. Now coming to the next part, this is the pin details that will be given in your board. Now here, this is a simple program that is showing you the rotation of the DC motor in the clockwise direction and in the anti-clockwise direction. Now first we are including the header file, LPC17XX header file. Then you are defining your main in integer mode. Now first we are supposed to set the pin number 28 and 29 of port 4 as equal to output pin. In order to do that, we are defining the port 4 as general purpose input output pin, and we are directing it to fast IO pin mode by setting a value as 0x3 followed by 7 zeros. Then once these ports are, that is the pin of 28 and 29 is made as a output port, and when that is equal to 1, the condition is while when it is 1, we are supposed to give the required datas for the fast IO pins. Now for the anti-clockwise direction, we are setting the 29th bit as equal to 0 and 28th bit as equal to 1. The value that we'll be giving here for FIO pin on port 4 will be 0x1 followed by 7 zeros. If you want to rotate the motor in the anti-clockwise direction, the value that we'll be giving here will be 0x2 followed by 7 zeros. Now the value is given for the direction of rotation. Now we are supposed to give the enable value. Now as seen in the previous table, the enable pin is assigned to port 2. The import to the 8th pin has to be made as equal to 1. Now if I take the pin from 0 to pin 8, here we are setting the 9th bit as equal to 1 in the 32 bit of port 2. So once this is done, your DC motor will be enabled and you can see the rotation of the DC motor. Now we'll see how to execute this program using the Keil version. Open this Keil version 5.2. Create the project with some particular name. So here, as you can see, I've created a project with the name as equal to DC motor. So once the project is created, you're supposed to go to target. Go to options for target. Here check whether your device is LPC1768 and select the option target. Check the clock frequency as equal to 12 MHz. Select the option use micro lib. Then go to output. click this create hex file option, give OK. Now this is done. Now you are supposed to open a new file. Okay, so the code is already available with me, so I'm copying it and I'll be pasting it here. So paste it, save it. I'm giving some name for it with an extension .c. I've saved it in here. Now once this is done, you need to add the files to the project. So add your file, then close. You can see the file that is appearing here. Now once this is done, compile your file and check for the errors, and then build and rebuild. Once this is done, you expect to download this hex file onto your evaluation board. So open Flash Magic tool. So browse your hex file, give open, then give start. Okay, so your code will be downloaded and you'll be able to see your output. So this is the board. Here we have connected the motor, DC motor is connected. Now once the code is downloaded, you'll be able to see the rotation of the DC motor. Now since the program is written for the anti-clockwise direction, it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. When I give the value as equal to 02 followed by 7 zeros, you'll be able to see the rotation of the DC motor in the clockwise direction rotation also. I hope this session was interesting and you were able to understand the configuration of DC motor with LPC1768 ARM controller device. Hello students, we have come to know how the DC motor works and the implementation is done. Now this is the list of the viva question that can appear corresponding to the experiment on DC motor, which is explaining the principle of operation of DC motor. Languages used in embedded C is explained. Now this question is explaining you what is back EMF and counter EMF with respect to DC motor, and the regulation of the speed is explained in this question. And this is explaining you when what happens when a DC motor is connected across an AC supply. Like this, many questions could be asked on DC motor. Few important questions I've picked here and it has been included as in viva questions. So try to prepare for these viva questions. I hope this experiment was interesting for you. Thank you.